our loss, we pour our praise to you only. And all the earth will shout your praise, hearts will cry, bones will see, praise. Hearts will cry, as bones will sing, great are you, Lord. And all the earth will shout your praise. Hearts will cry, as bones will sing, great. Thank you. rocks and you won't climb up coming after me.
Senior High Week. We are very happy to be ministering to you this week. We're excited. Our staff is excited. I'm one of the deans this week. And if you haven't seen our welcome video, you should really check it out. It's on the camp website. It kind of tells you how to approach a virtual Senior High Week this year. So Brian Redman, that's your other Senior High Dean, and I, we recorded it and kind of mapped it out for you. So you should check that out. So before we get started this evening with our message, I'd like to open with a word of prayer. God, we thank you that you rain blessings on us. We thank you for Sylvan Hills. We thank you for another great summer. God, we know that this is a little different this year, and we just pray that your Spirit's with us this week. God, I pray that you speak through me this evening, and that you put your words in my mouth, and that we hear what you want us to hear, God. I pray that you open some hearts and some minds this evening, that we can hear your message. And we ask all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. So my message tonight is called, Help Me, Lord, I'm Stuck. And our theme this week, if you haven't noticed, if you didn't get on the website when you were registered and check it out, our theme is stuck, with a big exclamation point. And we're going to be talking a lot about feeling stuck and the emotions that go with that and the feelings that go with that when we feel stuck in life. So have you ever been in a situation where you feel stuck? Now, I don't mean I was walking through the mud and the rain and I got stuck, or I put my hand into something and I couldn't get it out, so it was stuck. Not that kind of stuck. What we're talking about, what Brian and I are talking about, is when you make a decision in life, or when you've had a past choice or an experience, and because of that, you just feel stuck in place. You feel stuck and you can't get out. And we are going to look at the emotions that we go through when we feel stuck. And so we're going to look at some different topics this week in our week of camp. And so one of them is stuck in the past. And sometimes we feel, because of our choices and because of our experiences and the consequences of them, we feel like we can't get out of the past. We can't get away from the things that we've done. And another thing we're going to talk about is stuck in our feelings, stuck in our emotions, right? And sometimes our emotions get us down and we feel angry, or we feel sad or depressed or something like that. And we can't seem to just get out of that rut. We're going to talk about that this week. Sometimes we feel stuck in our own head, and we feel overwhelmed or anxious or worried all the time because of the things that are going on around us. And we're going to talk about how to get unstuck from that kind of situation. Another thing that we're going to talk about is, you know, sometimes in our lives, we just feel like our life is one big storm, swirling and whirling around us, and we have no control over anything that happens. And so we're going to talk about what that feels like and how we get unstuck from that storm. And sometimes we feel stuck in our faith, and, you know, we feel like we're not good enough, or we're not worthy of God's mercy or his love. And we're going to talk about that too, and how we can feel unstuck in that situation. And so maybe you're thinking to yourself, whoa, Jared, you're speaking my language right now. Yeah, that's me. I felt all of those things. I am all of those things. And if that's you, that's great, because I'm those things too. And I feel like we would be fooling ourselves if we said that we hadn't felt those feelings before, if we hadn't had those thoughts. Maybe we feel this current stress in our lives from the situation that's going on in our nation right now, in our world right now. That's okay. Everybody's feeling those kinds of stresses right now in their lives. Our goal this week, Brian and I, our goal, our staff, is to explore these topics that we feel stuck on and the feelings that go with them. And our hope is that you come to this conclusion that is expressed in 1 John chapter 3, verse 1, which says, "See what kind of love the Father has given to us, that we should be called children of God. And so we are. The reason why the world does not know us is that it did not know Him." Now, let me first tell you that my identity is not teacher or coach or father or husband. Those are all the hats that I wear, but that's not who I am. I am a child of God. You are a child of God. And which is why we chose the theme verse this week in the book of Isaiah, chapter 43, verses 18 and 19, which says, "Do not call to mind former things or ponder things from the past. Behold, I will do something new. Now it will spring forth. Will you not be aware of it? I will even make a roadway in the wilderness, rivers in the desert." Through the prophet Isaiah, God tells us not to worry about things in our past, not to worry about the things that we don't have control over. He is going to do something new, and He's going to make a roadway through the wilderness, a river through the desert. And those are things that normal people can't do. And that's because our God can do anything. There is nothing that He can't do. Do you know, we've lived these past 4 months in this craziness that we call life, right? And I'm sure that none of us have ever imagined that we would live the life of quarantine, right? A life where we have to wear masks all the time. A life where we can't see family and friends that we want to go and see. We can't do activities that we want to do. Our sports are cut off from us. Heck, there's not even baseball on TV. I'm dying inside because there's no sports for me to watch. Thankfully, the Premier League is breaking through the mold and we can watch some soccer. All right? And I know that, you know, you have done school online and you have done Zoom meetings out the yin yang. Not to say that our Zoom meetings in the evenings aren't going to be awesome, because they will be, so you should make sure that you're at them. But we've done all of these things. We've changed our lives because of the situation that we're in. And I know that we are so very tired of seeing our parents, aren't we? And our brothers and our sisters and our children every day of the week. No, I'm just kidding. I love my kids. But you know what? That's the life we've been living. And, you know, I got to tell you, I'm sure you're feeling that you want to go back to normal. I'm telling you, I want to go back to normal too. I am very ready for normal to happen again. But why we feel stuck when we're at home, and we might even feel a little claustrophobic, right? Because everybody's around us all the time. That maybe the people that we don't always want to be around all the time, like our parents, right? Just know this, God has a plan for COVID-19. And we have this hope that we find in Romans. In chapter 8, starting in verse 35, it says, "Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? Just as it is written, 'For your sake we are being put to death all day long. We were considered as sheep to be slaughtered. But in all things we are overwhelmingly conquered through Him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels nor principalities, nor things present nor things to come, nor powers nor height nor depth nor any other thing created will be able to separate us from the love of God which is in Christ Jesus our Lord." Nothing, not our past choices, not our failed relationships, not our family issues, not even COVID-19 can separate us from God. Nothing can separate us from God. And that's really cool, isn't it? Nothing can separate us from God. Now, have you ever wondered, and I'm sure you've wondered because I've wondered the same thing, God, what are you doing here? What is this virus? What is this sickness? What is going on? Why? And I tell you, I don't profess to know God's plan. I don't know God's plan. I'm not God. Contrary to popular belief, I am not God. All right? I'm just kidding. But I tell you this. Even though some doors are closed to us, we might have our sports closed. We might have school closed. We might have proms closed. We might have all of those things that we really were looking forward to doing. Some of those doors have been closed. God is opening other doors for us. But what we have to do is see what those other doors are, and we have to step through them. We can't get stuck in this rut of, I can't do this. I can't do this. I can't do this. We have to recognize that some of our doors are shut. And some are being opened for us. And that's the exciting part. Remember, our theme verse says, "Behold, I will do something new. Now it will spring forth. Will you not be aware of it?" This all seems pretty new to me. I've never lived through a pandemic before. I'm sure you never have either. And I know it gets us down, but this is what I've decided. I've decided to be unstuck. Unstuck, not stuck. I've decided to try something new. To try to experience Jesus in a new way. And I hope that you'll do the same thing. God has given us as Christians a new way to do ministry. To come closer together, but to reach so much farther because of the internet, because of media technology. And I have seen the fruits of this labor firsthand. Our church at Blanchard has been doing church online. We've been doing a parking lot service. Our preacher, Russ, has been doing revelation studies, videos during the week. We've got Zoom Bible studies and Sunday school classes happening during the week. We're seeing more people experiencing Jesus during this time when we're supposed to be indoors and stuff like that because of our technology, because of social media. And, you know, I've seen good things happen at our church because we've embraced the ministry opportunity that God has given to us. And it has been so cool to see us reach people across the nation and across the world. And we as Christians should be taking a step through that door that God has opened for us. We are helping people to become unstuck with our ministry. Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 and 6 says, "Trust in the Lord with all of your heart, and do not lean on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He will make your path straight." God knows the way, ladies and gentlemen. We just need to let Him lead us. We don't know what God's plan is for us. We don't know what His plan is for this virus. But we need to trust Him with all of our heart. It's exciting to do this new type of ministry, but it's also a little terrifying, right? But I know this, God has a plan. And our job as Christians is to make disciples. Jesus is very clear in Matthew 28, verses 19 and 20, when He says, "Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you, and remember, I am with you even to the end of the age." He has just given us a new method to do this, to do ministry, to spread His love to people. And at a time when our people, our nation, need the love of Jesus, what better way to spread His message? Jesus' love is for all. And there are many things, so many things that bring us down and get us stuck. So many stresses and worries in our life that we carry around with us. And they weigh us down. And sometimes they make it hard for us to move or to even breathe. And we feel like we're just swimming in mud. And we're just stuck spinning our tires, not getting any traction. Our past choices, our past relationships, our lifestyles, they can pull us in the opposite direction as God. Satan is very clever. Make no mistake, he is very patient. He will wait for you. He wants you to stay away from God. He wants camp canceled. He wants you to forget what it feels like to be alone with God. He wants you to be stuck right where you are. He doesn't want to see you happy. He doesn't want to see you encouraged. He wants this virus. He wants this seclusion in our lives. He knows that we are a people that love to be together. We're social people. We like to be together. And we get frustrated when we can't do that. And we get lonely. And when we feel like that, he starts to chip away at us. He wants rioting in the streets. He wants the hate. He wants people pitted against each other, because when they're doing that, they're not thinking about God. That's exactly what he wants. He wants you stuck away from God. You might be thinking, oh my gosh, Jared, this is awful. This is overwhelming. It makes me anxious. I need to go sit and have my calming goat somewhere. And I get it, but what can I do? What can we do? I tell you what we can do. We can turn to the love of Jesus. He can conquer all fear, all pain, all anxiety, all anger that we have, and we can become unstuck. Paul says to the church in Ephesus in chapter 3, starting in verse 14, he says, "For this reason I bow my knees before my Father. This reason I bow my knees before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named, that according to the riches of his glory, he may grant you to be strengthened with power through his Spirit in your inner being, so that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, that you, being rooted and grounded in love, rooted and grounded in love, may have strength to comprehend all with all the saints what is the breadth and the length and the height and the depth, and to know the love of Christ that surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled with all the fullness of God." That is powerful from Paul. And he says God's love is total. It reaches every corner of our experience. His love is wide. It covers the span of our lives, and it reaches out to the whole world. His love is high. It reaches to the heights of our celebration and our joy and our triumph. And his love is deep. It reaches to the depth of our discouragement and our despair and our loneliness. When you feel shut out or isolated, remember that you can never be lost to God's love. God's love for you is total. I recently read the book I Can Only Imagine by Bart Millard, and he's the lead singer. If you don't know the group Mercy Me, you should check them out. If you've never read that book before, you should check it out. There was also a pretty famous movie that went along with it. But in the book, Bart says this that really struck me. He says, "There is nothing I can do for Christ to love me any more than he does right now. There is nothing that I can do for Christ to love me any more than he does right now." My friends, that is so true. God's love for us, it never changes. It's constant. It is total, and it is unconditional. There is no catch, right? It is not an exclusive club. It is inclusive. It includes everyone. Why? Because you and me, we are children of God. God loves you so completely, no matter what your shame and no matter what your pain. God can bring you out of the pit. He can make you unstuck. All you have to do is lay your burdens down at the foot of the cross. All you have to do is lay them down at the foot of the cross. You know, while we are on this earth, we are both a work in progress, and we are already made whole because of the cross. The cross is enough. Jesus is enough. I hope that you are encouraged as well as excited for this week of camp. It is my hope that you will open up to God and that you will form a lasting relationship with him, that you will let him into your heart. Our goal this week is to recognize that sometimes we struggle and sometimes we feel like we're stuck in place, stuck in our past, stuck in our faith. And we can't get out of that on our own. Jesus is the only way. He is the only path. Remember, he will make a roadway through the wilderness. He will make a river in the desert just to reach us, just to reach you, because you are a child of God. My hope and my prayer is that you let him reach you. He will change your life. If you have questions, I encourage you to please ask. We will be having family time each night at 7 p.m. So look for that email on Zoom. There's going to be a link on the website that you can ask questions. You can ask to talk to somebody. And we would love to sit down with you. I encourage you to reach out to us at any time. If you feel led to make a decision for Jesus, please reach out to us. If you need some prayer, we would love to pray with you. We've got a great staff that would love to pray with you. We're going to have a great service on Friday, July 10th at the Blanchard Church of Christ. We're going to have a parking lot service. You can come in your cars. You can bring your parents. We got a big stage. We're going to have some live music. We're going to have a message. And then if you feel led, we would love to baptize you. We would love to see you make that commitment to Jesus and to change your life around. I would love to sit down and talk to you about Jesus and his great love that he has for you. And my prayer this week is that you can become unstuck. Let's close in prayer. God, we just pray that you rain your blessings down on camp, that you rain your blessings down on the people watching this video. God, we pray that you enter their hearts. I just pray, God, that you let them know that when they are feeling stuck because of something that they've done, whether it's in their past or whether it's in their faith or whether it's they just feel like they're just in a giant storm, Lord, I just pray that you will be with them and that you will be walking beside them, Lord, and that you will pull them out, Lord. They might feel like they're crushed, Lord, but you will lift them up. God, I just pray that you speak to them, that you speak to their hearts. God, send your spirit down to work and move, Lord, in this week at camp and in the people that are going to watch these videos, God. God, we love you so much, and we thank you for Sylvan Hills. We thank you for the people that make it work. We thank you for the campers that come out because they love you and they want to learn more about you. God, we just ask that you will be with them, and we ask that all in Jesus' name. Amen. Yeah.
crimson stain. He washed Elias. He washed Elias. He washed Elias. Left a crimson stain.